Hello, my name is André Kuipers. I am an astronaut for the European Space Agency. Together with Russia, America, Japan and Canada, we all joined the ISS, the International Space Station. That means that we do training in all these countries for work on board of the station. And here we are in EAC, in Cologne, Germany, the European Astronaut Center. And here we train on the European elements. For example, we have ATV, this is our European cargo ship. Here we see a part of the Russian modules of the space station. We have a Soyuz simulator, and very important for ESA, we have our Columbus module. This is a fantastic laboratory where we do a lot of work. And I would like to show you how it looks inside. Gravity affects a lot of things on Earth in our daily lives. And we're going to look at two phenomena, and that is foam and convection. Let's see how this is in space and on ground. So talking about convection, we first think of air. Hot air goes up, cool air comes down. We see it in hot air balloons. When you fill it with hot air, it rises. If it cools down, it sinks. Same with gliders. They use the thermals to get higher. But it also happens in water. Now in water, you know it may be convection. From swimming, you know that on the surface of the water it might be warmer than where your feet are, lower in the water. In oceans, it happens on a big scale. The cold water from the poles is heavier, it sinks to the bottom of the ocean, and then it goes to the equatorial regions where it's heated up by the sun, and then the warmer water goes up and flows back to the poles. It can take up to 100 years, but there is a convection there. So gravity affects air and water, but it also affects the combination of air and water, foam. Now foam, for example, in a bubble bath, is divided in three fractions. You have an air fraction, a foam fraction, and a water fraction, or fluid fraction. Now gravity plays a role there, because gravity pulls the heavier water down. So on Earth, the duration of the foam depends very much on gravity. So in space, this should be totally different. So today I'm going to practice how to do the convection and foam experiments in space. And then I compare the results from space with the results that you achieved on ground. And I expect that the results will be very different. What is your hypothesis?